And the first thing about Bluebeard was they said, no walls, no doors. This is not about architecture, this piece. It's about two people, alone, ostensibly alone. And it has to, all the decisions have to come from them. So then we developed the idea, Katrin and I, that the doors and the walls were their bodies, so that she opens him up and he opens her up, stuff comes out of her pockets, his arms, he cries the tears of the lake. Nothing is about, you know, a wall with a door and a flashing red light, which says, you know, fire behind the door, or smoke coming out of it, the smoke, but not in a different way. But to me, it was very important to say what the piece was really about. And so we then decided on a very open world, and Katrin came up with this beautiful idea, this huge, enormous sort of circular revolve, which is the moon, the world, a dystopian Garden of Eden. It's like, this is man and woman after the fall, alone. It's got a Beckettian quality to it. It sometimes very much reminds me of like a singing Endgame. So it's got all these associations, and
it's a fixed world, right? There's no escaping from that world.
And they don't get off the revolve
with each other.
And it's interesting. It's about we try to think about what lonely spaces. And of course, people tend to think loneliness is about, you know, someone sitting at their kitchen table, you know, eating alone in a small room with the television on, you know. And you can be lonely in a huge crowd if you're a queen. And you can be lonely in an emptiness in the desert. So this loneliness, you know, the audience have to really concentrate on these two people because they're on this empty, lonely operating table. It's like a dissection too. And you have to really watch them. And they go through an incredible ritual. I mean, there's more stuff happening in that 50 minutes on that empty revolve.